worrying is it that this radioactive material has been stolen? It's missing.
Well, the international community ranks radioactive material on a scale from 1 to 5, with 1 being the most dangerous. And this is a category 2 substance, meaning that short exposure will certainly lead to illness and could even lead to death. So if it's mixed with conventional explosive material and detonated in a bomb, it would have significant health and environmental effects for the region.
How widespread? Is that what you would call a dirty bomb? Is that just mixed with regular explosives and used in that way? And how widespread would the effect be?
Well, it would depend on the type and the amount of the explosive used, but it would indeed be a dirty bomb, and it would have severe consequences both for the population health and environmental consequences, because radioactive contamination is difficult to clean up. However, it wouldn't be quite on the scale of a nuclear weapon using highly enriched uranium or plutonium.
I understand that this radioactive material is in every country, and it's actually gone missing in large quantities in the United States and also in Britain. I mean, how often does this happen?
Well, materials like this have applications in medicine and industrial capacities, so it really is prevalent in most every country. The international community tracks about 40 instances of theft or loss of these types of radioactive materials every year. So it is a problem that the global community needs to do more to respond to ensure that materials are adequately protected and securely stored.
I mean, that just seems extraordinary to me. I mean, 40 instances a year. Who's stealing it, and what are they doing with it?
Yeah. Well, oftentimes, thieves may not even know what exactly they've stolen. There was a prominent case in Mexico last year where thieves hijacked a truck that had radioactive material, and they didn't realize that they had a Category 1 substance on board. Those hijackers were later killed by the substance. So oftentimes it's accidental, and sometimes sources just aren't securely tracked. So they actually end up being moved or disused, the country simply doesn't know where they are.
I mean, if this happens so often, I mean, what's being done to secure this kind of material? What is the way to secure it?
Well, the international community does have a code of conduct that gives states best practices guides for how to adequately secure radioactive sources, how to tag them, how to monitor their movements. And the upcoming Nuclear Security Summit in Washington at the end of March will be a great opportunity to remind the international community about the importance of taking these steps to adequately secure radioactive materials, to track them, to register them, and to quickly report any thefts or losses.
And so when it comes to other nuclear nations, I know there was always a talk after the breakup of the Soviet Union that, you know, stuff went missing. I mean, in the more well-known nuclear nations, what is the protocol for not just this stuff but other nuclear material? Is it well looked after? Should we be worried about stuff that's perhaps in the former Soviet Union or Pakistan or elsewhere?
Well, nuclear and radiological security varies widely from country to country. There are no legally binding standards, which is a huge concern. And we know from cases of smugglers being arrested in Moldova that radioactive materials have been taken out of Russia and the former Soviet Union and are often sold on the black market. So that's a huge concern. But it's a concern here in the United States, too. We have radioactive sources at over 2,000 sites across the country, and only about 800 of them have had upgraded security to meet the Department of Energy's requirements for secure protection.